Hello everyone, this is Marek Pavlos from NCmatic. Welcome in this week's Technical Tuesday with NXCAM, the series full of practical tips and tricks about programming toolpaths in NX. In this episode, I will present how you can analyze CAD model of the part before you start creating toolpaths. I want to stress that I'm showing only few of many available ways of doing it. But even before that, here is what I do at the very beginning. Optimize face tool from Synchronous Modeling Group improves quality of models which were imported from formats like step, edges and so on. If during export or import phase, cylindrical faces were for example divided in half or blend surfaces were changed to B surfaces, optimize face will fix it. Make sure that you don't use too loose tolerance here. So approximated faces will be created only if it will be possible within the tolerance. I will just select all faces and click OK. In the report you can see what exactly was modified. For example, some B surfaces were approximated to simpler shapes. And in case of curves, tolerant curves and splines were simplified to lines and circles. After optimization of our part, we can move to analyzing it. First, I want to look for undercuts. As always with NX, we have several ways to do this. For example, we could use draft analysis, but I will use slope analysis here. In this dialog, I should select faces which I want to analyze and choose vector which defines top direction. In data range section, I will set +1 and -1 degrees as range of color map. This way, I can easily spot first undercut. Pink faces have positive slope, green ones are vertical, and faces colored with shades of blue are undercuts. If we will use wider range of color map, we can analyze also steepness of faces. It is worth to experiment with this. Let's take a closer look at this undercut. If you will activate this setting in Customer Defaults, you will see also this Label tab. It allows you to dynamically analyze the slope angle. Just click this option and move cursor around faces. What's more, if you will click at the face, it will add a label which will be showing you angle in the chosen point. Label will stay visible even after you close this dialog. To return to normal display of the part, just change shading type. And to display colors from last analyze, choose face analysis like this. Next option which I would like to show lets you find what is the smallest radius value and where it is at the part. This option is called simply minimum radius. And after selecting all faces, it will display resulting information window and small vectors will show you where is this radius at the model. We can try it also with another part. And here is the minimum radius. I will show you now two options, which are very handy during CAM programming. First one is geometric properties. I already have shortcut created. In one of my previous videos, I was showing how you can add shortcuts. After starting geometry's properties option, just move your cursor around faces, which you would like to get information about. Watch minimum radius value. If it is positive, radius is concave. Negative value means convex radius. If it says infinite, face is flat. This tool is very helpful for me and I use it a lot. If you want to get even more information about face, select single face and choose object information. It will open information window with details of this face. Most interesting parameter for me is surface type. It tells me if face is planar or cylindrical. This information is useful when you are wondering how to machine this face. Other types can be toroidal, blend, bisurface, conical, spherical, and so on. Another useful option lets you find and distinguish small concave radiuses. It makes it easier to choose proper tools later. It is called Concave Faces. When we select all faces of the model, it highlights only concave faces within defined range. In this case, I will use range from 0 to 10. As you can see, for each radius size, we can apply separate color. And it is not everything yet. We can also add labels. Colors and labels stays visible even after we close Concave Faces tool. Let's try this option also with another part. As you can see here, in case of blend with variable radius or B surface, it displays range of radius instead of constant value, What I showed you today are just few example ways of analyzing model of the part. I'm sure most of you are using also other methods, so feel free to share it in comments below. And if you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share it with other CAM users. All the best and see you in the next Technical Tuesday with NXCAM.